part of the precentral gyrus. Here, the body is represented upside down. Face and arm, they are represented in the lower part, while legs and sphincters, they are represented in the upper part. The parts of body which carry out skilled movement, right? And the parts of body that are most frequently used, they carry the largest area of cortical representation. So parts of body which carry out skilled movements like fingers, thumb, like tongue, they represent largest area of cortical representation, right? And the parts of body which are most frequently used, again, they carry the largest area of cortical representation. Each cerebral hemisphere controls opposite half of the body. Okay? Now, if these axons of motor cortex, they descend downward and they form corona radiata, fan-like projection, that is called corona radiata. Now, again, fibers from larger area, they are condensed into a fan-shaped area that is called corona radiata, right? This corona radiata, if involved by a vascular event, would result in, I told you that motor cortex agar involved hoga, either there would be no focal neurological deficit or there will be minimal weakness or there will be minimal weakness of thumb maybe. You may have a minimal weakness of index finger, one index finger, or there would be no focal neurological deficit, or there will be a deficit, maybe a monopresis. So reason behind that is these fibers, they are largely distributed, they are widely distributed in cortical area. So a bigger infarct even in this area would result in minimal deficit. Now these fiber from here, they are condensed into a fan-shaped area. This fan-shaped area is called
corona radiata.
Corona radiata. So there would be a clot here. It would result in hemipresis. But again, this hemipresis would be a differential hemipresis, differential. So either arm would be more weaker than leg, or leg would be more weaker than the arm. This is called differential stroke. Is it clear? So see, this is the, these are the cortical areas jahan aapko lateral ventricle nazar aana shuru ho, usse upar cortical area. So yahan agar bada infarct bhi hoga to either there would be no weakness. Ab hum corona radiata ko dekhna chahte hain. Corona radiata jab aapko lateral ventricle nazar aana shuru ho gaya to wo area corona radiata, lateral ventricle ke just laterally corona radiata ka area. So if anterior cerebral artery is involved, there would be differential stroke. Legs would be more weaker than the arm. One leg would be more weaker than that side, arm of that side. So there would be hemipresis, maybe right hemipresis, but right leg would be more weaker than the left leg. And if MCA is involved, then arm and face would be more involved, and leg would be less involved. ठीक है? Again, ये area, अब आपको अगर corona radiata का area देखना है, तो कहाँ देखोगे? जहाँ lateral ventricle आपको नजर आ, body of lateral ventricle नजर आना शुरू हुई, उसके just lateral आपका कौन सा area है?
Corona radiata.
अब corona radiata आपको ये आपको body of lateral ventricle नजर आनी शुरू हुई. जहाँ ये body of lateral ventricle, where the body of lateral ventricle divides into two portions, anterior horn and the posterior horn. Then, अब area just lateral to this is corona internal calcium. So, I again move to the neuroanatomy. We said axons of motor cortex, they descend downward and they form a fan-like projection that is called corona radiata. So here, if there is involvement by a vascular event, there would be a differential stroke. The fiber from here, pass through the anterior two-third of posterior limb of internal capsule. Anterior two-third of posterior limb of internal capsule. So internal capsule would be like that if you have any page.
Copy the number.
This is, and these are the anterior horns, these are the posterior horns.
Ball point yahi karegi, koi pen lena padega hame.
This is internal capsule. A nucleus here is called caudate nucleus, and laterally this is putamen.
Caudate and putamen.
So this area is
internal capsule.
Now where do you see this internal capsule? See here. Here this is the body of lateral ventricle. Again this body is divided into, this is divided into anterior horn and the posterior horn, right? Again, if you see, there is an area, this hypodermis, this is internal capsule, and this area is caudate nucleus, this is putamen, and here is the thalamus. So caudate, putamen and thalamus, and this is the area when this area would be involved. Now axons of motor cortex, they descend downward and they form a fan-like projection that is called corona radiata. Then these fiber pass through the anterior two-thirds of posterior limb of internal capsule. Here a small infarct, a lacunar infarct, would result in dense hemiplegia because the fibers there condense in very small area. These fiber pass through midbrain and midbrain area, to be remembered, is they pass through the middle 3/5 of cerebral peduncle in the midbrain. This is the only thing you need to remember. These pass through a middle 3/5 of cerebral peduncle in the midbrain. The fibers, then they are scattered in the pons. At the lower border of medulla oblongata, they form a protuberance that is called pyramid. They cross over to the opposite side. Now, from where we started? From cerebral cortex. And where we have reached?
Medulla
oblongata, and then they descend in the lateral part of the spinal cord. They cross over to the opposite side and then descend in the lateral part of the spinal cord. So where we started from cortex, and where are we? In the spinal cord. And in which part of the spinal cord? Lateral part of the spinal cord. So one descending tract you have known without any effort. This is corticospinal tract, and this is lateral corticospinal tract. So from cortex they pass to axons of motor cortex, they descend downward, they form a fan-like projection that is called corona radiata. They pass through, these fiber pass through the anterior two-third of posterior limb of internal capsule. Then these fibers pass through the middle 3/5 of cerebral peduncle in the midbrain. They are scattered in the pons. Then in the lower border of medulla oblongata, they form a protuberance that is called pyramid. They cross over to the opposite side and then they descend in the lateral part of the spinal cord. This is called lateral corticospinal tract, also called pyramidal tract. Right. When you talk of word pyramidal tract, and other word comes extra pyramidal, right? So the system, what is extra pyramidal? The system outside the pyramidal tract that is concerned with the movement and posture. This is called extra pyramidal system. Basal ganglia, thalamus and cerebellum, that's all. Basal ganglia, thalamus and cerebellum. And now if somebody asks you, what is extra pyramidal system? System outside the pyramidal tract is extra pyramidal system that is concerned with the movement and posture. This is basal ganglia, thalamus and cerebellum. Basal ganglia, thalamus and cerebellum. Is it clear? Yes, sir. Some of me, I said